Hello and welcome to this special edition of Kids Zone and the Bible Discovery Hour here at the General Conference, the 51st quadrennial session of the General Conference for the African Methodist Episcopal Church. I am Reverend Sam and I am so grateful to be able to share with you today's lesson on the power of the gospel. The power of the gospel. Wow, when you say those words, power and gospel, they cannot just be said with any other random tone. You have to say it with conviction because the word power is a strong word. Power, or it can have a soft touch. Power of the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ, that Jesus Christ was born. He came here to earth to live and he died, but he did not just stay dead, but he rose again. Well, let's backtrack and figure out, how does the power of the gospel operate in our lives? How does it make sense? And what does it do for us and our faith? A couple of days ago, I was moving around my house and watching my new favorite television show that I'm binging on Netflix, as well as washing clothes in the washing machine and doing something else on the stove, multitasking like many of us normally do. And all of a sudden, there was thunder outside, dun-dun-dun-dun, and power went off in the house. All the appliances and electronics reset. They were off for a few moments and then they came back on and the time was off because there was no power in the house. And when, you know, the house loses power at your surge box, it resets everything and causes everything to go chaos and chaotic and just all over the place. Well, in today's lesson, the power of the gospel teaches us about the importance of what it means to have faith, to be bold and not ashamed of the gospel, and what it can do for our lives and how we can share the gospel. I want to invite you to pull out your Bibles and look along or read along as we listen to the key verse for today. I'm going to read it off my phone. And it says, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel. It is the power of God for salvation to everyone who has faith, to the Jew first and also to the Greek." Well, in this scripture, Paul is writing in this letter, we also call this an epistle, to the Romans. While because Rome was the center or the epicenter of where Christianity, the gospel was being spread from. And so to reach so many people, Paul continued to write to Rome in order to get this message passed out and to make sure it spread, because he was so excited to hear and to see that the word of God was being spread throughout the area, starting from Rome. And he was so excited about it. He addresses these things into the letter and talks about not being ashamed. What does it mean to not be ashamed? He is, one, talking about what it means to be bold and to have this ability to proclaim the good news because of what he experienced in his life. If you recall, Paul had one of the most interesting stories in the Bible of how he came to know Jesus Christ and have a relationship with God himself. Paul was not one that grew up in what we would consider to be church or considered to be a Christian household. Christianity was still formulating at the time. So Paul grew up in a different tradition and grew up and as an adult became a persecutor of other Christians. He was given a name before, his birth name was Saul, and it wasn't until he meets Jesus Christ for himself and has his own conversion, which means that he accepted Christ for himself and had developed his own relationship, that then his life was changed. And because of that moment and the feeling that he had inside, and he knew that the change that was happening to him was happening on the inside, it caused Paul to be on fire for God. So throughout all of these letters that Paul writes in Romans and Ephesians and in other books of the Bible that we are attributing to the writer Paul writing letters to other groups of Christians, he is writing because of what his own faith is being worked out. And so I can imagine maybe many of you have ever journaled, or if you've written letters to other people, or written statuses on Facebook or any other social media. Sometimes when things happen in our lives, we thank God because we appreciate what God is doing in our lives. Sometimes we have questions about things that are happening. Sometimes we want to encourage other people and we write it on our status or write it in our journals. And so Paul's letters, his tweets and his Facebook posts and his YouTube video channel, blogs, imagine all those being put into context in the times where the Bible was written and Paul's letters or his thoughts became what we know now to be books of the Bible. And he's writing because he's so excited. He knows that there is truth in the gospel because of how his real life is starting to play out. He knows because his life has value and meaning now because of his relationship with Jesus Christ. And because of what he knows to be true. And so he tells the Romans, I am not ashamed of the gospel. And what some of the things that happens to Paul, if you go back and read his story, is that Paul himself is persecuted, thrown in jail. He gets a chance to meet the Romans, but not the way that he wanted to meet them. And the power of the gospel that he's talking about can be quite scary. Why? Because the gospel will change your life and move you to a different direction. And it moves you towards a different direction sometimes that's not necessarily your plans. And that can be a tough pill to swallow when you accept that the vision board that you may have created for yourself or the plans that you may have written in your journal for yourself that you want to create your goals. When you accept Jesus Christ into your life and when you follow God, sometimes our plans don't always match up with God's plans. And that could be a really, really sticky situation for a lot of people. And a lot of people tend to wrestle with those things. I mean, if many of you who may be watching right now, you may know what it's like to go in between of trying to figure out your pathway or your plans for life, because let's face it, all of us ask these big questions to God about, why am I here? What did God make me for? What's my purpose on earth? God, what's the plans for my life? And as you're asking those questions, as you're reading the Bible for yourself, as you're learning more from being surrounded by other Christians, because that's the great power of the gospel, is the gospel will transform your life and help change you so that you can get on the pathway that God wants you to be on. Just like Paul, who was once Saul, who was going on his own pathway and on his own plans, when he met God, it changed his life and it changed it into a different direction. So the power of the gospel can be that surprising for your life. It has the ability to change the course of your life, to change it so that you can actually do what God may have created you to do. And it may be scary or frightening in the beginning, but what Paul teaches us is that when you give and sacrifice your life to God, you may not know what tomorrow may bring, but Paul continues to give thanks to God. He continues to surround himself by other believers and Christians, which we are doing right now. Many of us are gathered in Orlando, gathered in virtual spaces, connecting with each other on Facebook or other social media as we're watching the worship and participating in the business of the church. Maybe you have started to attend church back in person or still connected virtually online. The biggest thing that we know about the power of the gospel is that it requires connection. It requires us to be connected to other believers so that we can feel encouraged. So just when that power goes out in your life, when it feels like you're dark, when you feel like you're alone, when it feels like the world is completely shutting in on you and sometimes it feels silent, connection, by being connected to other people, staying in constant communication with other church members or other Christians, helps to encourage you so that you can become strong. When you are connected to God and connected to others, you begin to share your faith. And so I invite you to begin thinking about what does it mean to be connected to God? To what does it mean to have the power of the gospel moving in your life? And what does it look like? Maybe you're writing and you can write in your journal. Maybe that comes out in a really fancy TikTok video. Maybe you want to draw a picture and maybe post it online. Should not be ashamed or shy or scared or feel that you cannot share the gospel. But God wants us to be bold about our faith. Well, what do you tell people? What do you share? How do you share the gospel? Well, you can share the gospel in many ways, but one of the ways that I suggest is by building a relationship with other people, becoming their friends, learning what makes them happy, what they are excited about, going out with other people and being a friend and supportive to them, just like Christ is a supporter and a friend to us. And to not just be connected to them, it's one thing to just say that, yes, I have a relationship with God, I have a relationship with other people, but if you don't have action, if you're not doing good by people, if you're not just showing some signs that you actually love God and you love other people, how you treat people will really show whether or not the power of the gospel is moving in your life or not. The power of the gospel is one that brings light in darkness. It's the one that brings hope when you're feeling sad. It's the one that encourages when you're feeling low. It is the one that is able to change the entire world. What would it look like if our church today was really, really, really excited about the power of the gospel? Well, we are already there. We're sharing the gospel to the world into many different spaces across the entire globe right now. So what you should do, click share right now. That's one way of sharing the gospel. Secondly, find a way this week to whether it means you're changing your social media, whether you're going to create a video, maybe you're going to go out with some friends and find a really nice safe way to kind of show signs of love and to demonstrate the gospel of Jesus Christ. You can do it no matter how old or how young you are. God is with you as you share the power of the gospel. Why? Because the gospel, remember, changes lives. And someone's life really needs to feel the glow of Christ. Maybe that is you. Maybe that's a loved one. Maybe it's a friend or someone else that you don't know. You never know until you try. Don't be ashamed. Be bold. For God has not given us any spirit of fear, but of love, power, and a good mind. So go out there and share the power of the gospel with someone else. I'm Reverend Sam, and thank you for allowing me to be in your homes with you today.